How does the integrated graphics in AMD's new Ryzen 5000 laptop processors compare against Ryzen 4000 from last generation? I've compared the iGPU in both in 10 different games at all setting levels to show you what the differences are between Zen 2 and Zen 3. I have already compared these two processors in this video over here, but I only briefly touched on the integrated graphics differences, and quite a few people in the comments wanted to see more. These are the differences in specs between these two processors. In terms of the integrated graphics, both are Vega based, however the newer 5800H has an additional graphics core with higher GPU frequency. It's important to note that while this is meant to be a GPU comparison, other differences between these two processors will also play a part, such as the improvements of going from Zen 2 to Zen 3. These include higher processor speeds, extra cache, and more. To be honest, I would expect most laptops with Ryzen 4800H or 5800H to be paired with discrete NVIDIA or AMD graphics, but that's not always going to be the case. Even with gaming laptops like both of these, some people will disable the discrete graphics when running on battery power to get more battery life and still play some games on the integrated graphics, as the iGPU is just less power hungry, so it will last longer. Now for the 4800H, I'm using my trusty Lenovo Legion 5, and for the 5800H, I'm using the XMG Nier 15, which is the same Tongfeng chassis as the Electronics Mech 15 G3 that I recently reviewed in this video. For this testing, both laptops have the discrete NVIDIA graphics disabled through Device Manager, and both were also tested with 16GB of memory and dual channel at DDR4-3200 CL22, and it's important to note that the memory tested was the same, as this will affect iGPU performance. So with all of that in mind, let's get into the gaming results. I've tested 10 games at all setting levels at 720p. As you'll see soon in the results, 1080p just isn't worth testing outside of esports titles. Let's start out with some esports titles, as these run well on integrated graphics. Fortnite was tested with the replay feature, so the exact same test run was performed on both machines. I've got the older 4800H shown by the red bars, and the newer 5800H shown by the purple bars. I've also tested all available setting presets, which are listed on the left with the lowest down the bottom and highest up top. In this test, the 5800H was 20% faster at epic settings, and about the same margin at low settings too. CSGO was tested with the Ulytical FPS benchmark. At minimum settings, the 5800H was reaching 19% higher average FPS. However, with all settings maxed out, the gap lowers to an 11% lead, possibly meaning the difference between processors matters more at lower settings where we're less GPU bound. It's not all gains though. Dota 2 on the other hand saw the smallest difference out of all 10 games tested. At the highest ultra setting preset, the average FPS was just 3% higher with the 5800H, while the 1% low was basically the same. Overwatch on the other hand saw minimal differences at lower setting levels. Then at the highest epic settings, the 5800H was 11% faster than the 4800H. The results here should be very comparable, as I completed the exact same test pass through the practice range multiple times. Rainbow Six Siege was tested with the game's benchmark using Vulkan. This test saw the biggest performance difference out of all 10 titles tested, with the newer Zen 3 system reaching 22% higher average FPS at the highest ultra setting preset. Even the 1% lows with Zen 3 were near the average FPS from Zen 2 at all setting levels, so a reasonable single generation improvement. Let's look at some more resource heavy games. Cyberpunk 2077 was only able to reach 30 FPS with the newer Zen 3 processor at 720p low settings. So, not ideal, but probably still better than consoles. Jokes aside, the 5800H was reaching 20% higher average frame rate with the highest ultra setting preset. Red Dead Redemption 2 was tested with the game's benchmark tool. Ultra settings was reaching 18% higher average FPS with the 5800H. But as we can see here, there's only about a 2 FPS difference. This is another resource heavy game, but at least at lower settings, we're able to reach higher frame rates compared to the previous one. Shadow of the Tomb Raider was also tested with the game's benchmark, and at the highest setting preset, the difference was extremely close to the last game, with the 5800H reaching an 18% higher average frame rate. Lowest settings was close to 60 FPS with Zen 3 this time though, presumably as this is an older game compared to Cyberpunk and Red Dead Redemption 2. Speaking of older, Battlefield 5 was able to surpass 60 FPS at low settings 720p with the 5800H, so quite playable, and even Zen 2 wasn't too far behind. At the highest ultra setting preset, the 5800H was reaching 16% higher average FPS when compared to the 4800H. Control is a game that I've found to generally be heavy on the GPU, so I was expecting this test to show one of the larger differences out of the titles tested. However, this was not the case. At high settings, the 5800H was reaching 14% higher average FPS, a below average result out of the 10 games tested. Here's how much faster the iGPU was in these games with the Zen 3 5800H when compared to the Zen 2 4800H. We're looking at at the differences between maximum setting levels where we're likely to be more GPU bound. But regardless, as mentioned earlier, some of these differences are of course going to be down to more than just the improvements to the iGPU. On average in the 10 games tested, the newer 5800H was able to run these games around 15% faster. This is about expected when we consider that the jump from 7 to 8 GPU cores is a 14% change. Outside of gaming, I've also tested the Blender Open Data benchmark with the BMW test using OpenCL with the integrated graphics. The 5800H was around 16% faster in this one, so a similar margin to what we just saw in the majority of the games. I've also measured the total system power draw from the wall while the Blender test was running. The 5800H system was using 20% more power, but these results can't be perfectly compared as there are other hardware differences between these laptops. And that's also the reason I haven't bothered measuring temperatures on both of these laptops. They have different cooling solutions, so it's just not fairly comparable. And same reason we're not looking at battery life, they just have different sized batteries. In an ideal world, I would have the exact same chassis to do a fair comparison, but in the real world, that rarely happens. And this is what I've got to work with. Where the integrated graphics are really going to shine is in the lower powered U-series processors, as these are rarely paired with discrete graphics because they're found in thinner and lighter designs. Based on the data provided by AMD, it looks like there are some reasonable improvements going from the 4800U to the 5800U in games. But let me know if this is something that you want to see compared in a future video. For now, you can check out how the 4800H compares against the 5800H in CPU heavy workloads over in this video, or check out the full review of the 5800H laptop in this one here. Otherwise, as usual, if you're new to the channel, then make sure you're subscribed for future laptop content like this. Seriously, there's a lot more on the way with all of these new models.